I sat down by Runnigan's corner, one morning I did stray. I met another rebel there, this to me did say. I've orders from our captain to assemble at Dunbar, but how were we to get there without a motor car? Well, Barney dear, be of good cheer, I tell you what we'll do. The British, they are plentiful, the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnston before we walk too far, and we'll give the boys a jolly good ride, Johnston's motor car. When Dr. Johnston heard the news, soon put on his shoes. He said the case was urgent, little time to lose. He wore a fancy castor hat, on his breast a star. You can hear the din go through Glenfin, Johnston's motor car. But when he reached the railway bridge, the rebels he met there. And he knew the game was up, so damn it he declared. I've got an English permit to travel near and far. You can stick your pass right up your ass, we want your motor car. What will my loyal brethren say when they hear the news? My car, it's been a commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. They give me a receipt for it, a sign to Captain Marr. When Ireland gets her freedom, boy, they'll get your motor car. They put the car in motion and felled her to the brim. With guns bayonets shining, while Johnston hid his grin. Then Barney hoist the Sinn Féin flag, fluttered like a star. And we